Hi guys, I hope you're having a good day. So for those of you that don't know, I live in the UK and it has been unusually hot here this week, which has made testing hardware a little bit tricky. We don't really do air conditioning as it's just not needed most of the time, but yesterday when I checked the room temperature it was about 32 degrees, or 90 if you're in America, which means I am way behind where I planned to be on making videos. If you want to break hardware, then benchmarking in what was probably a 35 degree room is a really good way to do it. It's certainly a good way to break me. But as this is YouTube, I could do with getting a video out as it has been a week, so I thought I would quickly share with you my thoughts on AMD's Wraith Stealth that comes with the Ryzen 5600X. Something I am probably pretty late to the party in talking about, but I fully intended to skip AM4 and only picked up a Ryzen 5000 series because of all the comments about bottlenecks on my 6700K and Cyberpunk, which prompted me to do some research into people's understanding of how CPUs behave in actual gaming situations, and well, that's a whole rabbit hole that is coming soon. Anyway, I picked up a 5600X as it's not too expensive at the moment and is near the top of the gaming performance charts. Terrible idea, don't do this by the way. I haven't really used a stock cooler in a really long time, as they're generally just not very good. AMD's bundled coolers have generally got a reputation for being a little bit better than most. So I thought I'd run some tests on its out of the box setup, as that's what a lot of people will be doing. Besides, unless I wanted to go out and buy a cooler specifically, I would just have to use my Arctic Liquid 240mm AIO on it, which is frankly overkill for a 65W CPU, but as it is in the case for the 6700K when I'm testing that, it will actually be what I'm using day to day. Anyway, when I opened the box and saw the reality of the Wraith Stealth, I pretty much knew this wasn't going to go very well. But this is how AMD ship it, so this is how I decided to test it. So here is a screenshot from a GPU bound test in Cyberpunk, and as you can see, the Wraith Stealth is failing hard to keep the 5600X cool. This is in its stock configuration, 70% load, 86 degrees, admittedly in a really hot room, but this is about a minute into the test and it's already reaching concerning temperatures. Maximum temperature for a 5600X is around 90 to 95 degrees, and before I managed to complete my test run in Cyberpunk, it actually crashed and CPU ID's hardware monitor that I had running in the background reported a maximum of 91 degrees. That was a somewhat extreme situation, but only one caused by hot weather in a generally cold country. Oh, and for those wondering, I'm using a Fantex P500A case with two additional fans from its default configuration. So a case with very good airflow, it's just a hot summer's day. Here is the temperature monitoring from 3DMark TimeSpy I used to check my GPU overclock was consistent with my settings on the 6700K. Yet a hefty overclock on an RTX 3070 still runs cooler than the Wraith Stealth can manage. Today though, it's only low 20 degrees and not low to mid 30s, which is roughly speaking the standard hardware test temperature. So I fired up Blender this morning just to run a quick test before I decided if I want to do any more tests with this cooler, and as you can see, in an approximately 22 degree room, the Wraith Stealth is keeping the 5600X to 80 degrees while under 100% load for a few minutes. What it could not do is maintain clock speeds, and in fact what's happening here is that it is ramping up to around 70 degrees fairly quickly and then dropping clock speeds to help keep the temperature from climbing too quickly from there. After the load is reduced, it then takes well over a minute to drop down to the 50 degree mark, which isn't exactly a low temperature for an idle CPU anyway. I will finish this video and take a note of how well the cooler handles rendering what will be a fairly short video, and I'll include that in a more in-depth look at the 5600X. But please, if you're running a 5600X with this cooler, please just stop. It is clearly holding back the maximum potential of the 5600X. While recording this, I think I decided I won't be running any more tests with this cooler because the only thing left to find out is when it kills the CPU, and I don't want to be doing that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, like, share, comment, subscribe, all that stuff, and thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time. Goodbye.